Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. Thanks, Don. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Herkimer College Athletic Hall of Fame induction ceremony. I'm Jason Paulus from WKTV News Channel 2 here in Utica, and I am honored. Thank you. I'm honored to serve as your Master of Ceremonies tonight. On behalf of Herkimer College, I would like to recognize and thank this evening's sponsors, Fitzgerald DiPietro and Mahonis CPAs, AmeriCU Credit Union, and D'Arcangelo and Company. At this time, please help me welcome some very special guests this evening, our current Herkimer College student athletes.
Go on.
One more round of applause for our student athletes. Now that our audience is complete, I would like to introduce our platform party. Mr. Donald Dutcher, Dean of Students and Director of Athletics. Mr. Nick Leno, Senior Vice President for Administration and Finance. And Dr. Kathleen McColgan, President of Herkimer College. Now, as a former sportscaster, I can attest to the phenomenal athletic program here at Herkimer College. The college has a reputation as one of the nation's most successful junior college athletic programs. This is truly the home of champions. Tonight, we gather to celebrate and honor seven individuals and two teams for their extraordinary contributions to the college through intercollegiate athletics. At this time, I have the great pleasure of welcoming the president of Herkimer College, Dr. Kathleen McColgan, to the podium.
Thank you, Jason. First, let me start by saying, wow. Just wow. It is an amazing sight to see the auditorium filled with so many generals. Welcome to the fifth induction ceremony for the Herkimer College Athletic Hall of Fame. Before we begin, I would like to take a moment to recognize several individuals who are in the audience with us this evening. Herkimer County legislators, Ray Johnson. Ray? Mark Arecki, Mark. And Herkimer County Administrator, Jim Wallace. Thank you for your support. Herkimer College Foundation member, Mr. Nick Leno. And the Executive Director, Rob Fowler. Tonight we have previous inductees, our Hall of Famers. Chris Whitman, class of 2017. Pepe Aragon, class of 2015. Paul Wiram, class of 2015. Thomas LaPuma, class of 2011. And Sharon Powell, class of 2011. Thank you for being with us this evening. Athletics has a rich history here at Herkimer and is sewn into the very fabric of this institution. The pride and recognition that athletics brings to Herkimer College goes well beyond the record books, and the opportunities that athletics provides for our student athletes are beyond measures. The Herkimer Generals program began with five sports in 1970 and has grown to 21 varsity teams. Yes, thank you.
Good job.
With the most recent addition of being esports. And let me tell you, our esports team is proving to be quite the team, winning a national championship in their very first competition year. Also with us this evening are Herkimer College's most recent national champions. Avion Harris. Avion, are you here? Yeah. No, just... just stay right there, because we want to congratulate you. 2022 men's track and field 1500-meter national champion. Our 2022 men's baseball team. Led by coaches Jason Rathbun, Lane Potter, and Greg Guerin, went on to win the National World Series Championship. Congratulations. Yes, it has been said, and it is true, Herkimer is the home of the champions. To date, the Generals have achieved 65 national championships. And we're not finished. 131 Regional Three titles, 171 Mountain Valley Collegiate Conference Championships, and 4 first place finishes in the National Alliance of Two-Year College Athletic Administrators Competition. We have a solid history, and we are still in the game. But not only is Herkimer an athletic powerhouse, our program places great emphasis on excellence in the classroom and in the community. Our athletes are students first, earning higher academic grade point averages than non-athletes. To date, Herkimer has had 31 teams earn National Academic Team of the Year awards. Our teams have also been recognized numerous times with the NJCAA Region 3 Sportsmanship Award for outstanding sportsmanship displayed by our athletes and our coaches. These recognitions and accomplishments of our individual student athletes, our teams, and the entire academic program does not happen simply by luck. It takes a dedicated and talented team of highly motivated and committed individuals, a team of individuals that bring their A game to campus every day. At this time, I would like to invite all of our coaches, our athletic trainers, and our athletic directors stand to be recognized. Thank you. And lastly, to the class of 2022 inductees. Your achievements, both while at Herkimer College and beyond, are a great source of pride for all of us here at Herkimer. Your legacies have a permanent place in our record books and in our halls. Thank you to each and every one of you for the inspiration you are to all of us. Congratulations and enjoy the evening.
Please welcome Donald Dutcher, Dean of Students and Director of Athletics, and the Chair of the Hall of Fame Selection Committee.
Thank you, Jason. I'd like to welcome all of our honorees, former honorees, retired, and current faculty and staff, our current student athletes that are here with us tonight, and other special guests. I'd like to, at this time, recognize our selection committee. So if you are here, I know we've had a few that could not attend tonight, but if you are here, I would like you to please stand to be recognized as part of our selection committee. John Campagna, Cynthia Gabriel, Sharon Howell, Ryan Packard, Hank Testa, and Chris Whitman. If you could please stand. Thank you. The committee is the one that goes through all of the nominations and then weeds out who they feel is the incoming class of 2022 and who belongs to be here tonight in our Hall of Fame. So, and then a special thank you. As we all know, running an event or planning an event is not an easy task. And if these individuals are here now, I would like them to stand as well. Vicki Brown, John Campagna, Rob Fowler, Sarah Gegler, Julie Lewis, and Rebecca Ruffing were part of our event planning committee. So thank you for your time and efforts. And as you see tonight, the videos, I do want to give a big thank you to Sean Lynch. Sean Lynch was a former student here at Herkimer, and this was one of his summer projects of putting this video together. He is currently out at the Arizona State University doing an internship out there, working with their athletic program and doing some sports information director duties with them. So a big thank you to Sean Lynch for his time and effort putting this together. And I'll end it with this, and you'll hear a little bit more from Mr. Lano tonight. You heard all the accomplishments that Dr. McColgan mentioned of our past student-athletes that have walked through these doors and our current student-athletes that are still here that are defending national champions and are going to try to defend that title again. But what I need, okay, obviously with winning becomes cost with that. And to keep a successful, thriving athletic program, we are going to ask that you somehow can give back for these current student athletes sitting in here. One of our major initiatives this year is to take buses to games. All of us remember riding and packing in the vans. I don't know if I ever rode with Coach Wareham in a van, the way he drives, but that's one of our goals this year to do that. So at the end, you'll hear a little bit more from Mr. Lano on that, we're trying to provide a safe, effective way for our student athletes to continue that success to keep Herkimer at the top. So thank you everybody for attending tonight. I hope you have a great evening. I think you're in for a great show. And Jason, I'll turn it back over to you.
Thank you,
buddy. Don, thank you. And now for the Herkimer College Athletic Hall of Fame Class of 2022 inductions. The first inductee this evening is Mr. Kenneth Black. Kenneth was a standout basketball player under legendary head coach Jack Aloffs in 1978. Kenny was the first Herkimer College student athlete to be named an All-American. Please direct your attention to the screen.
The Herkimer College Gymnasium has been the host of many talented players throughout its rich history, some of whom have played professional basketball, others who have captured the awe of thousands with their remarkable ability. Known widely around famed New York City streetball courts such as Rucker Park during his playing career, Kenneth Black first made his mark at Herkimer College.
When it comes to Hall of Fame inductions, I don't know how you cannot think of Kenneth Black.
I grew up in Herkimer. My brother played on one of the first teams here in 1971, and I was fortunate enough to watch many of the basketball teams since its beginning here at the college. And there's no question, Kenny Black was the first big impact player that we had in the basketball program. Since then, we've had quite a few, but Kenny, you know, for the first 7 or 8 years of basketball being played on the campus, was definitely a standout player, and his impact was tremendous.
And when you walk down the hallways here at Herkimer College through our esteemed athletic building, there's a name that pops out every time I walk that hallway, and it's the first ever All-American here at Herkimer College. Kenneth Black was a honorable mention 1978 men's basketball All-American selection. And I think what that means to this institution and to this athletic program is when you do walk those halls and you're a prospect coming here as a potential student athlete, this guy paved the way for countless of All-Americans that have walked through these hallways after him. And for him to be up there and his name being the first one ever, I think just he set the bar, he set the, the high profile of what it takes to be a student athlete here at Herkimer. And, you know, from the stories I've heard, Kenneth was an amazing player. Kids were in awe when they came and watched him. John Campagna, who's been part of our athletic program here for a number of years in the institution as well, remembers as a child coming up here and watching Kenneth Black play. And he would tell us stories how he would go home and pretend that that was him on the basketball courts here in the village of Herkimer as well. So, Kenneth, I can't thank you enough for what you did and what you did for the athletic program, the men's basketball program here at the college. You set the bar high, and hundreds of student athletes have followed in your footsteps being named All-American. So I congratulate you on this special night.
Kenneth, please join us up on the stage. Come on up.
Thank you.
Wow. Hey, this is unbelievable. You know, when I was playing here, I was just playing, excuse me, I'm a little nervous, for the love of the game. We didn't have too much to do in Harlem. So when you played ball, we played it for real. And Jack Aloff, my coach, he was a great coach, great mentor. When he told me, when I came up here, he saw my skill set, he said, shoot the ball. Black, shoot the ball. I kept saying that. And, you know, telling me to shoot the ball is like ringing a dinner bell. So that kind of set the tone for me to do what I did on the court. And it accumulated to this. And this, out of all of the trophies and awards I won in my basketball career, and I won a lot, this right here, I think, is the one I'm going to cherish the most, because it's an accumulation of everything that I did. And it all started here in Herkimer. And for all you student athletes coming in, I congratulate you guys. You picked a great school. Do great things. Mr. Aloff used to tell me all the time, just be yourself and be great, and your accomplishments will go noted. You will be noticed. And you know, 18, I never thought that, but now at 62, I'm here accepting a Hall of Fame award. And it don't get no better than this for me. And I just appreciate everybody for coming. Thank you.
Our next honoree is Mr. Wendell Williams, a 2014 graduate who won 6 national championships in 4 separate track and field events while at Herkimer College. He also played men's basketball for 1 season, averaging 18 points, 4.9 rebounds, and 6.2 assists per game, and setting the school record for most points scored in a single season. Wendell was signed to an NFL contract by the Houston Texans in 2016 as an undrafted free agent and is the only Herkimer College alumnus to have played in the NFL. Take a look at your video screen.
I had the privilege of coaching Wendell for 2 years. I got to know Wendell through Coach Lee. Coach Lee came in and said, hey, I got this basketball player for you. He's quick. He can jump. And I'm like, great. So Wendell comes out for the team, and we're watching him. And needless to say, he was quick, and he could jump. And the other coaches and I are like, wow, he's going to do something this year.
When Wendell did play basketball, Wendell did some things I've never seen a kid do on the basketball court, you know, dunking over a 7-footer. At Nationals, I think he went on a run there where he didn't miss a 3. So, amazing athlete, great person, attitude, just everything about him really brought the team together and the guys together.
One of Wendell's things I'm most proud of was his sportsmanship. He was, like I said, an amazing athlete, and at the end of every race, he would wait at the finish line, shake their hands, high jump, long jump, didn't matter. He would shake their hand. And this was an athlete people saw winning multiple events. He was good. And when you see an athlete like that, a lot of times they will just walk away. They will not acknowledge you. And that was not Wendell. He was down to earth. And you would see crowds along the long jump pit, the high jump, when he was running, and they would cheer him on because he kind of stole their hearts. Because he, like I said, he was kind-hearted and he had that sportsmanship.
Basketball, one of the best accomplishments I think we made that year was winning Region 3 championship. We had 3 key players, Wendell being one of those 3. And, you know, all three of those players have 4 fouls with 10 minutes to go in the game, and we're down 7, I think. And Wendell just kind of made some things happen. We went on a little run there, and we ended up winning the regional championship off of his leadership and ability. And again, he just did some things in practice I've never seen either. Really focused on getting better with his shot. You know, Wendell wasn't a fantastic shooter, but he really worked on his game. You know, we did some drills with him and just put in the extra time.
We were at a meet and they were giving out t-shirts if you won your event. So Wendell won the 100, the 200, the long jump. I think he won a couple more events, but I can't remember. But Wendell came up to me and gave me this shirt, and on the back it says long jump. And he says to me, Coach, he goes, you were a long jumper, right? And I'm like, yeah. He goes, here, this is for you. And it melted my heart, because how many athletes would actually come up and give you an award that they won? And it just warms my heart that I had an athlete think of me like that.
Wendell was a great student athlete for our campus.
You are one of the most amazing, talented athletes I have ever seen come through Herkimer. I was an athlete here myself. I coached here for 38 years. And I've seen a lot of athletes come through our doors. And you, to me, personally, I think was one of the best that we have ever had in our Herkimer family. And I was very proud to have you on the team. We were very fortunate, and we were very proud to have you part of our Herkimer family. So Wendell, congratulations.
Wendell, come on up.
We're very fortunate, and we're very proud to have you part of our Christmas family. So, Wendell, congratulations.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for coming. I just want to say, you know, thank you to the coaches, the staff, Kyle, for keeping me out the cold tub. It feels like a cold tub in here right now. I don't know if you guys are cold, but I'm freezing. A big shout out to Mr. Dutcher. I don't know if you guys know that your athletic director is a really, really good person. He believes in his athletes. I ran into a situation a year when I was here, and he went to bat for me. And it was really at a time to where everyone's back was against the wall with the decision he made. And he made it in my favor, so I want to say a special thanks to you on that. And I have a few words for my fellow athletes. I know you guys probably didn't have too much choice of being here right now, but hopefully I could give you, you know, just a little bit of words of encouragement while being a general. The path I chose was never made for me. There was no dirt road to walk on, and there for sure was no pavement, and it always was uphill. I built my path, and so can you. Looking back on the sacrifices that led to some of the decisions I made, I thank myself today. Believing is half the battle to seeing your future self come to light. Stay disciplined. I never wanted to practice, work out, study. I still don't like doing those things today. Discipline will always have your back when motivation lets you down. Have a plan. Failure to plan is, in other words, planning to fail. Be conscious. Your decisions in the moment can be life-changing, whether for good or for worse. Consistency. This is a building block for success. Not too many people that are successful aren't consistent. Persistence. Never get discouraged. Never back down and never give up. Keep knocking at the door. If it doesn't open, make your own key. Lastly, life provides you with lessons, not losses. Learning from the lesson is how you grow through life without any losses. I appreciate you guys for coming. Thank you.
Our next inductee tonight is Victoria Companion, a standout runner in both track and field and cross country. Victoria won the 2014 track and field national championship in the 10,000 meter race and was a two-time NJCAA All-American runner. She was named Herkimer College Women's Athlete of the Year in 2014 and 2015 and is the only woman in school history to win the award twice. Take a look at the video.
I had the privilege of coaching Tori in track and field for 2 years and as assistant cross country coach for 2 years. Tori was a very well-known high school runner, and I knew a little bit about Tori because her sister Tiffany went here and she was on a national championship track team. So we had a little in with Tori. Knowing Tori's being a little shy, a little laid back, I knew Herkimer would be a good fit for her. I didn't want to see her get lost at a four-year school. And through Tiffany and her family and Coach Sodaro and I, you know, we talked to Tiffany and she decided to come to Herkimer, which we were very pleased with.
She was a very quiet, hardworking individual. She never really said much. She just definitely let her legs do the work.
Her freshman year, my runners, they train under my assistant coach, Charles Maxson. He was my distance coach. And he's an ex-Marine, and you can hear him in the gym, you can hear him in the next gym, you can hear him across the field. which is a good thing because a coach needs to be heard. If you're trying to shout things to your athletes, they need to hear you. And that's his way of coaching. That's not something Tori was used to. I got a call from Tiffany and she's like, what is up with this guy? She says he's yelling at her. She's ready to quit. She's all upset. What's going on? And I'm like, Coach Maxson is an ex-Marine. That's his style of coaching. He's not yelling at her. He's yelling so she can hear him. So I asked Coach Maxson to tone it down, and Tiffany talked to Tori about understanding that was his style of coaching. And the two of them actually worked very well together after that. Tori was a hard worker. Even though she was very shy and timid, she was very motivated and determined when she got on the track. When she wanted to achieve something, she did it. We adjusted her training schedule several times because what we thought where she was at, she would prove us wrong and we would have to up things because she was so determined of what she wanted to accomplish at the end of her season.
I loved watching Tori run. She just made it look so easy. She was just a very consistent runner. She gave me a better appreciation of running, and it helped pave the way for my future teams.
At Nationals, she won the 10K. She won the steeplechase. 10K, for people who don't know, is 25 times around the track. Steeplechase is 12 and change times around the track with barriers and barriers with water. And as Tori was running, you could hear the other coaches say, don't worry. She's going to get tired. She's going to come drift back. You're going to be okay. She's not going to hold this pace. And they kept, telling their athletes that. And Tori was doing negative splits, which means every lap she did, she got better. By the time the race was done, Tori was somewhere between 300 and 400 meters ahead of second place, and she set a national record in the steeplechase. With Tori winning the 10K and the steeplechase, she received the track athlete of the meet. And again, that is beating everybody out in the 100, the 200, the 400, the 800, the 15, the 5K, the steeple, the 10K, the 100 hurdles, and the 400 hurdles. So there's a lot of girls that she had to beat out to win this award. And we were extremely proud of her for that.
She owns the course record at Delhi, the time of 1917 for the 5K race. And to this day, they hand me this course map, and it still has her name on it. And every time I see that, it gives me goosebumps to see that when she ran that.
So Tori, congratulations. We are very fortunate to have you on the team. I really enjoyed coaching you, and you're very well deserving of this award. So thank you for being part of our Herkimer family.
Victoria, come on up.
Congratulations.
It is truly an honor to be inducted in the 2022 Herkimer Athletic Hall of Fame. All those practices running up the dreaded front hill paid off. Cross country and track during my college years gave me memories, friendships, and opportunities that I'll forever be grateful for. I wouldn't have been the runner I was without my amazing coaches, Sharon Howell, Steve Sodaro, and Charles Maxson. Also, a huge thank you to the athletic administration and my supporting family. I really enjoyed my time here at Herkimer College and will always be a general thank you.
Danny Nicosia, a 2015 graduate, was a two-time NJCAA All-American Women's Soccer, for women's soccer, and two-time team MVP. Danny totaled 22 goals and 12 assists in her 2 years at Herkimer. She continued her academic and athletic career at Queen's University in Charlotte, North Carolina, where she earned a bachelor's degree in sports management and a master's degree in communications. Danny is currently an assistant athletic director for digital and creative media at Lenoir Ryan University in Hickory, North Carolina. Please watch our video.
I remember going and watching her when I was recruiting her, and she was just dynamite. She was all over the field. She was an excellent leader on the team, always on the field. I coached her for her freshman year, and I was here for her sophomore year, and she was just nonstop. It didn't matter if it was practice. It didn't matter if she was a freshman and there were sophomores who were the ones struggling. She would push them. She would pick them up. She would constantly, you know, do what she needed to do for the team to be successful. She definitely deserves Hall of Fame status here. Like I said, she was the leader, the controller. She did everything the right way. She didn't cut the corners during the sprints and during the workouts. She pushed everybody to do their best just like she was.
I remember our second year, I wasn't able to play anymore, but we had just this one fun night of practice. It was a late night. We just did some sort of volleyball game with her, like soccer volleyball. And if you lost, you had to do some sort of dance move or some sort of something. And she would do the worm across the whole soccer field if you let her.
I know several teammates that were on the team with her, and you know, they were a close-knit group, and she was part of that. She was one of those girls that just everybody wanted to be around, and everybody wanted to, you know, be like her, because she was that girl.
It was like no other. I've played a lot of soccer with a lot of people in my life, and to play with Danny was like playing with no other. She is what you wanted as a teammate and definitely as a friend.
She had so many concussions throughout high school and whatnot because she was a three-sport athlete. You know, especially in basketball as well, she was an animal. And I remember talking to her mom about that. The one game where she got a really, really bad concussion, and ever since then, she's been wearing that helmet. But like I said, it didn't slow her down any, and she owned it, you know?
Even when she went down to Queens to play in North Carolina, my mom and I went down to watch her, and she wasn't able to play. The aura she gave off to her teammates down there, she wasn't even playing. She just, the support she had and everything she had going on down there with that team, she brought that to the table. Her energy, her knowledge, her drive, her love for the game, she's like no other person I've ever watched him play.
She kind of blossomed here. She opened up here, and I can actually remember her telling me at one point that she was nervous about coming to Herkimer because of certain situations, but I know that after that first year here, she told me, she's like, thank you for getting me there, because it really helped open me up. And it did. You know, her parents said the same thing. She opened right up. She came out of her shell, and you know, she was very social after that, and she knew what she wanted and she went for it. So, and she's very successful at what she's doing right now.
Her knowledge for the game and her drive, she was always making everybody laugh. She is incredible.
Danny, come on up.
I came with a little bit more of a speech, so bear with me. Good evening, and thank you all for being here. First, I want to start off by saying thank you to Donnie and the Hall of Fame Committee. To be thought of to receive this honor is incredible. My time here at Herkimer was nothing short of amazing, and to be inducted into the Hall of Fame just, you know, kind of encapsulates the whole 2 years that I had here. What many people don't know, and Amy kind of touched on in the video, Herkimer wasn't really the choice of school that I wanted to make coming out of high school. It definitely wasn't the place where my parents wanted me to come to school. But if you were to go back and ask them now, it's probably the best decision I ever made for myself was to come here. It's really hard to decide where you want to spend the next 4 to 5 years of your life and what you want to do when you're 18 years old. Add into that I was in a self-discovery stage of my life and pretty much revolted anything that my parents wanted me to do. But the only thing that we could agree on was that I wanted to play soccer in college. And I was able to do that here thanks to Amy. And she's my first thank you of the night. Amy was the woman who made coming to Herkimer possible. She put my parents at ease when they were unsure of me coming here. And once I was here, she was like a mother figure to me, in addition to being my coach. My freshman year, we weren't very good. I think we went 500 on the year, but honestly, it didn't really matter because we were having fun. Amy made it fun, even on the hard days. She picked you up when you were down. She supported you when you need to, and she told you to sit down and shut up when you were being too much. She loved all of us for who we were and what we brought to the table, and I couldn't have asked for anything better. Amy supported me through my first year of college, which was really rough at some points, and let me figure out life away from home. With some guidance, obviously. I needed it. Like I said earlier, Amy was my mom away from home and will forever be someone I know I can call at any point in time, and she'll be there. So Amy, thank you for being a supportive mentor, a friend, and a coach. I'm gonna keep going, so just bear with me. My next thank you goes to my coach my sophomore year, Ryan Brooks Newton, who came in. Ryan was the most influential coach I've ever had. He was supportive in the right ways, but he also knew how to push me to the next level and get the most out of me as a player and as a person. He gave me a different outlook on the game and got me to see and play the game at a new level. My sophomore year, he took us to the national championship. We finished third, and during that time period, I was probably playing the best soccer of my life and operating at a high level, and I credit a lot of that to his leadership. In addition to being an amazing coach, Ryan helped me learn how to be a leader to my team and gave me a lot of opportunity to grow in that area. Off the field, he was even more supportive. He pushed me academically, which was an area that I really struggled, and he pushed me to grow as a person, make better decisions, and be the best me that I could possibly be. Without Amy and Ryan, my career at Herc wouldn't have been what it was. I wouldn't have been as successful as I was without them, either of them, supporting me day in and day out, on and off the field. My time at Herc also wouldn't have been complete without the friendships I made while I was here. Some of my best friends to this day are the group of friends I made in my 2 years here, and I'm so thankful they were able to be on that journey with me. This is a group that was there every step of the way through the good and the bad and who are still here. We have the same group chat that we started our sophomore year of college, which was almost 8 years ago. I say all of that to say thank you to everyone who came across my path while I was here, everyone who crossed my path through the good and the bad, and there were some really bad times. You helped me become who I am today. Lastly, I want to say thank you to my parents for all of the love and support they have given me through every stage of life. Although Herkimer wasn't in the vision, I think we can both agree it was the best thing for me, as it allowed me to mature in areas I didn't even know I needed to mature in. Coming here gave me the opportunity to go on and play at the next level at a 4-year school. Coming here allowed me to figure out who I was, not just as a soccer player, but as a person. It allowed me to try new things, meet new people, and thrive in different areas of life. Herkimer will forever hold a special place in my heart. The walks from Meadows to Rez and back again, the rides up to see the windmills, the bus rides to games, the stops in Amy's office before class, and all the crazy things we did that I won't talk about here will never be forgotten. Herkimer is a really special place. We might not realize it while we're here, but it is. As cliche as it sounds, cherish the moment while you're here. Take it in every day to its fullest. Take the extra time with the ones who are important to you because you can't get that time back with great friends. Enjoy it while you can. Play every soccer game like it's your last. And remember, once a general, always a general.
Jimmy Smith led the Herkimer Generals basketball team to a fourth place finish in the 1987 Division I NJCAA National Tournament in Hutchinson, Kansas. Now, at that time, there was no separation in division levels, and Herkimer was the only non-scholarship team in the tournament. Jimmy was the anchor of that team. He led the tournament in scoring and was named the most valuable player over a future NBA All-Star. Take a look at the video.
Jimmy, when I first met Jimmy Smith, it was back in the 80s when we played against each other. Jimmy played for Proctor. I was at Notre Dame. Jimmy was a dominant force at the time in the Central Oneida League, along with Steve Babiarz, and became an extreme force and very successful in high school in this region.
As a leader on the team, Jimmy always carried himself to the point and extent that he wasn't a big talker, but he showed his actions on the court, which certainly led others to follow his lead.
Jimmy at any point was explosive. He was dominant as far as his size, his speed, and his overall aggressiveness. He was somebody that was not to really fool around with because he was gonna take you to the rim every time.
He had it all. Jimmy was very team-oriented, very elusive player, very hard to guard, was always around the ball. Defensively, offensively, he was our main scorer. He was our number one go-to guy.
Back in the 80s, when he played in the 85 through 87 era, there was not really divisions in basketball. There was one division. And for Jimmy to attain an All-American status both years, third and second team, was amazing because there wasn't Division 1, 2, 3. There was one division. And him, along with Chris Whitman, brought them to the Final Four in Kansas is amazing. Jimmy produced all the time. He was dependable.
Jimmy was a dream for Coach Alofs and us as teammates. So he brought certainly a lot of team attributes to the game and to the team. However, he could, if we were down, he could get us, back out in front in a hurry. Both offensively and defensively. He was around the ball. He just had a knack for being around the ball and getting the ball and making things happen. Very humble gentleman. This is long overdue in my eyes for Jimmy to be finally inducted into the Hall of Fame, and certainly a great honor. I do talk to Jimmy. I called him a few weeks back to congratulate him on this great honor. I don't see him quite as often as I like. But, we talk probably once or twice a year. When I do see him, it's just like old times. It's, I think with someone that you've had that success with, building a friendship, becoming a teammate, it literally is like no time has been lost. We're just back to talking memories and asking how each other's families are doing, and you know, it's very easy and smooth, and he's a great man and a great father.
He was a true general, a great athlete, and a great person. Congratulations, Jim.
Again, being a little bit biased here, say that you're one of the best athletes ever to come out of the college in my eyes, and I think a lot of other people would join that argument, not only in basketball, but all sports here. And this college has had tremendous amount of success in all sports that they've endeavored in, with lacrosse and softball and basketball and soccer, of course, all the championships they've had here. Congratulations, well deserved, and thank you for all the great memories.
Jimmy, come on up.
Good evening, guys. Thanks for coming. My friends and family was like, you got your speech all set? I say, yeah, I got this. I lied. I thank everybody. Thank the committee for everything, for this. This is awesome. It's not easy. And thanks a lot, Danny. I'm going nowhere as long as you did, so not doing it. I went to Herkimer. It wasn't on my choice. I just for like young scholars, athletes, and everything. I wasn't always good in basketball. I used to wait till the lights came on at nighttime for them to pick me. So I would stand there till they got done playing. Everybody went home and ate. Had my dad come looking for me. But I'm out there by myself under the lights, practicing. Never got picked. That's where hard work's come in. You practice, make yourself better. Never give up. Always work hard at what you do, especially in school. That was one of my biggest things. Wasn't that I wasn't able to do it, I didn't want to do it. And that probably was the reason why I came to Herkimer. But they said everything happens for a reason. And I believe that this is two of the best years of my life here. All the play, Coach Alofs, oh my God, I love that guy to death. The great Jack Alofs was a very great man. Good there for you, family oriented, great coach. And I just wanna rest in peace, Jack. I love you, we all love you. My players, I wouldn't have gotten none of this without my teammate. I don't know if y'all ever seen what's the basketball with Shaq and them Blue Chips. That was our basketball team. Jack went to every little country, little hick town, and this and that, and got all of us together, and we finished fourth in the nation. you gotta love it. So thank you guys again. Love you guys. Pleasure, Chris. You the man, dude. I love you.
Gino Barbuto, a 1986 graduate, was a two-year player on the men's soccer team, earning second-team All-Region honors. His team was the first in school history to qualify for the regional soccer playoffs. Gino went on to have a successful career with East Syracuse Chevrolet. He started as a service advisor in 1986 and moved his way up to eventually becoming general manager and operating partner. Then, he became owner of the dealership from 2011 to 2021. Throughout his career, Gino has helped recruit players for the Herkimer Generals and has been a generous supporter and donor of the athletic program. Please watch the video.
Gino Barbuto. What can I say about Gino? I've known Gino for a number of years. He was a student athlete here. He was a men's soccer player. And his family, the Barbutos, have a real rich, strong tradition of being excellent soccer players. And Gino, I got to be in touch with early on in my career as a player here. His cousin Ambrose was actually my roommate here at the college for 2 years and played soccer with me.
Gino Barbuto has had a tremendous impact on the college. He started his career here as a student athlete, successful in the classroom, successful on the field. But more importantly, as an alum of the college, he took his education and really became a successful businessman. And with that success was also success for the college. Gino has always been there to help us out financially as we've asked him for support. And with that, that's priceless.
What Gino has done is he's really come in as a contributor and a friend of the college. He's worked with our men's soccer program in providing some donations to help curb the cost of equipment expenditures that were passed on to our student athletes now that do not have to be passed on to those student athletes. So your generosity, Gino, is greatly appreciated. And, one day you might go in as a soccer player here too as well, but we'll wait for that day to come.
Over the last years, Gino, for the most part, the relationship has been through philanthropy. We have had a number of discussions on his role in helping the college out financially. And never once has Gino ever said no to any request that we might have had.
I'm so happy to announce that you're going in as a contributor to our Hall of Fame here at the college. And I appreciate all that you do and thank you from the bottom of my heart. Not only are you a contributor and a friend of the college, you're a friend of mine. And I wish you many years of happiness and success in our continued work and relationship together. So congratulations once again, Gino.
He's a true alum. He's a true general that has made an impact here by giving back to his alma mater. Congratulations, Gino.
Gino, come on up.
Good evening, everybody. I want to start by thanking the committee and Don Dutcher for this honor. It's great. I want to congratulate all the inductees tonight, all the athletes that deserve to be in the Hall of Fame. Congratulations, everybody. I had the pleasure of watching Jimmy Smith play. I'm a year older than he is, but his My second year was his first year. He was fun to watch. He was the real deal. So thank you. I want to thank my family for taking the trek up through A to come here tonight. Herkimer is near and dear to my heart. It's an honor to have come here. I appreciate Perry Nizzi convincing me to come here and play. And, you know, we don't have the national championships that a lot of the teams do, but, you know, we always say you never forget your first, and we were the first to make the regional, so nobody can ever take that away from us. To all you student athletes, you know, take advantage of what you have here. And all I can tell you is it's a great time, and 2 years go by at the blink of an eye, and you'll never forget your friends or your teammates here, and a lot of our teammates still talk, and Nizzy's doing a great job down at Hamilton, and I can't say enough about what Pepe's doing with the program here. Not only was he a great player here, but he's a great coach, and you soccer players right now should be proud to have him as your coach, and maybe we can win another national championship this year. You know, as far as being, there's two things that are near and dear to my heart. When I was fortunate in life and worked hard and became successful, but there's two things that I believe in, and one is Herkimer County Community College. So I've always supported the program here. And the other thing is near and dear to my heart is Golisano Children's Hospital, because there's nothing worse than a sick child. So, you know, everybody that's got healthy children, you're blessed, but the people that don't and need help, I'm happy to support them as well. So, you know, over the years, Don and I have become friends, and he's a great athletic director, but he'll call me as a business owner looking for advice. Sometimes I feel like his older, much better-looking brother, by the way. So, but I've always, you know, tried to support him all I can, and, you know, it's mind-boggling to me, no offense to the politicians out here, but I've been on the state board for the New York State Auto Dealers for 11 years, so I'm in Albany a lot dealing up there. And when I see, you know, schools like Herkimer that need to raise money so we can get transportation for student athletes, and then, you know, there's funds going to private universities for different things, it's mind-boggling to me. But, you know, when you get a chance and you talk to your local politicians, it's always good to put a bug in your ear about whatever, and this is a good cause, and things that really should come to the forefront. So, you know, I wish the university the best of luck. You know, it's an honor to be mentioned with not only all the athletes, but, you know, I remember when I was here, you know, Coach Wareham and Coach LaPuma and guys that I looked up to as a young kid, you know, and I don't know who was a worse driver, Wareham or Nizzy, but it's probably a toss-up. But, you know, to be in the same wall with those guys is absolutely amazing. So all I can say is good luck to the student athletes, and thank you very much for this honor.
Hank Testa graduated from Herkimer College in 1977. And after earning his bachelor's degree, he returned 2 years later to teach accounting. And he never left. Hank has served for 43 years in a variety of capacities as a faculty member, administrator, and a coach. Upon his retirement from administration in 2014, he was honored with the title of Associate Dean Emeritus. Throughout his career, and into retirement for that matter, Hank has been a vital member of the athletic department. He was head baseball coach from 1995 to 2005, earning Region 3 Coach of the Year and Mountain Valley Conference Coach of the Year honors in 2001. He joined the men's basketball program in 2004 and served as an assistant and associate head coach until just this past year. And in 2019, Hank helped aid the team to a national championship victory. Please watch the video.
So when you think of the best that have been a part of the Herkimer College athletic program, it's hard not to think of Hank Testa.
Hank joined our basketball program in 2004. In his first year, he was very helpful to me. It was just my second year coaching, and I didn't have any assistant coaches. So having him a part of us, he would help educate me on, you know, the academic situation here at the college, the student athlete, how classes and schedules balance with practice, games, travel. So he was a huge asset for me personally in getting my career started. I feel not only Hank is a huge asset for our basketball program, but our athletic department. Hank, you know, never batted an eye at anybody's asking for advice. It doesn't matter if it was another coach, another assistant coach, another student. Any time somebody needed something, especially academically, advice, advisement, Hank was always, he would literally drop what he was doing and go, you know, help that student athlete and or coach.
Congratulations, Coach Testa. It's an accomplishment. It's well-deserved. You've served a lot of time at this college, had many roles throughout the college, somebody we always leaned on.
Regardless of his relationship, he treated everybody with the utmost respect. He gave everybody an opportunity to be successful, and he was a huge asset to our program.
He's made relationships with not only the coaches and his fellow coworkers and associates, but the players as well. I know for myself, I was only a team manager for the men's basketball program for 1 year. Every time he'd come to the gym, "Hey, Sean Sturr, what's up?"
One of the proudest moments I've seen Hank have during a basketball game was 2011. We were at Mohawk. The game should have been over. We ended up hitting a shot. They missed two free throws. Melvin Gager ended up hitting a three literally at the buzzer. And, you know, at the time, everybody's going crazy. We're in Mohawk's gym. And, you know, it's like, oh my gosh, how do we just win that? And then we got to get everybody together off the court. And, you know, we go back and we watch the film. And, oh my gosh, it was the excitement that he showed. You know, it was amazing to see him that excited. And we also noticed he was starting to get a little bit more bald, but that's besides the point.
As a player, you were a father figure to me. Growing up during a tough time trying to raise a son and going to school at the same time, you were always there and understanding and somebody I could lean on for support. And then obviously my whole professional career, I owe to you to help getting me this position and helping us transition it to a national championship program. And without you, none of that would be possible. I can't thank you enough, Coach.
In 2019, I believe it was our seventh appearance at Nationals. Winning those three games, you know, it was a big deal. And I think at one point, you know, we're celebrating or whatever, and I think I was actually on the phone, but at one point I looked over and Hank was just sitting on the bench, and you could tell he was just taking it all in. You know, he's been here a lot of years, and I'm sure that's a moment that he was hoping to have the opportunity to get. And happy for him, happy for our program, happy for his family, Donna, everything that they've done for our program and the athletic department. Game days on Saturdays, you know, I'm the one who sets up the gym. We come in, you know, early on Saturday morning, you know, we get the gym ready for the doubleheader. Hank always was here before me. And he's there to help me set up the gym. He's sweeping the floor with us. He's, you know, changing railings in the bleacher. He's putting chairs down, and, you know, and then this is a Saturday morning, and he turns around, he goes back home, and then he comes back in the afternoon and watches the women's game and coaches the men's game.
I can't thank you enough, Coach, and everything you've done for this college. I love you. We'll always remember the good times that we've had up here.
I love Coach Testa, and I'm thankful he's been a part of my life.
Hank, once again, congratulations on this Hall of Fame induction. Very deserving. Thank you for letting me be a part of it. Thank you for everything you've done for me personally, professionally, and, you know, I wish you and Donna and your family the best of luck.
Coach Testa. Now, Hank, 1 minute before we proceed here. You want to go first? You want to go first? All right, you're going to talk first.
Before I get started, I was in Kansas when the basketball team was there with Whit and Jimmy, and I've coached, I think, about 600 basketball games. I've scouted probably another 600 basketball games. Jimmy Smith's the best basketball player I ever saw in the junior college level. First, I want to thank the dais. That, you know, it's funny, I've worked for all of those folks directly at one point or another. I've been here for forever. I really enjoyed all of them. I also want to recognize the committee that I was on, and I was sitting there. I thought we were all done. I stood up. It's time to go. And Don says, well, wait, we got one more to do. And I said, no, I've got my list here. It's worth through the list. And he said, no, we have a coach. And I said, oh, okay. So I sat back down. He said, no, you have to get up. I said, what are you talking about? He said, no, you're the coach. And I was like the most surprised guy in the college, for sure. I've been here since 1975. I graduated from here. I played baseball here for Jack Alofs. Everybody thinks of Jack as a great basketball player, which of course, a basketball coach, which of course he was. But he was also a great baseball coach. He was a great baseball umpire. I was a baseball umpire for many years, and I umpired many games with him. And I got my start and caught the coaching bug, really, from Jack. I worked here, I'm very proud to say, I worked here in the 70s, the 80s, the 90s, the 2000s, the 2010s, and the 2020s. So, and you're probably thinking, well, he must have started when he was 11, because he only doesn't look that old. Coaching, if you're going to be a college basketball coach, particularly at the division level, junior college level, you're going to make a bunch of sacrifices, and your family is going to make a bunch of sacrifices, and your friends are going to make a bunch of sacrifices. And so my speech today isn't a speech. Mine is a thank you to all the people that got me here today. And that, of course, starts with my beautiful wife, Donna, of 42 years. You know, one of the best things was that we were able to teach here, and I was administrator for many years, together. And it was wonderful having her at work with me every single day, because after work I didn't get to see her that much between practices and games and travel and scouting. And, you know, it was different before. Now you can go watch a game streaming live. And when I coached, you had to go someplace and watch the game. There was no such thing. She's a professor emeritus here at the college, and we are going to celebrate our 42nd anniversary next week, and I love her dearly. Thank you, sweetie. I also would like to thank my children. My daughter, Molly, and my son-in-law, Phil, are here tonight, and my daughter, Mia, son-in-law, Rob, and my granddaughter, probably, Roisin, out in Arizona, will probably watch this later, and so I want to let them know how much I love them and thank them. My brother, Phil, is a big part of my life. He's having some health problems and can't be here tonight, but I know he'll watch this too. My brother graduated from Herkimer. All of my daughters graduated from Herkimer. I know I saw him here earlier, but didn't get a chance to talk to him. Tom, I know Tom LaPuma is here. Tom is our original athletic director, and like, we wouldn't probably even be here doing this today if it wasn't for Tom. And so, Tom, if you're here, would you stand up, please? I also want to thank the three athletic directors that I worked for. Sid Fox, who hired me to be the baseball coach. Tom Findura was here for a few years and still comes to our basketball games. And Troy Tucker, who is has moved on to University of Maryland and Northampton Community College. But I really want to thank Donnie. You know, he is not only a terrific athletic director, he's just a terrific employee and a terrific guy. And the one story I'm going to tell, we were heading out to the Nationals the year we won it, and we're in Chicago, and I fly from Rochester, New York to Chicago, and then from Chicago, I'm going to fly to Rochester, Minnesota. I get on the plane goes to Rochester, Minnesota. We circle the airport for an hour. They can't land. Plane flies all the way back to Chicago. So I call Don just to see where he is because I know he's coming out, and he's in O'Hare Airport, and I'm in O'Hare Airport. And he says to me, I said, what are you doing? He says, I'm getting on the plane. I said, no, you're not. I said, I was just on the plane. He said, no, I'm getting on the plane right now. I said, you're not getting on the plane. And about 2 seconds later, he said, I'm not getting on the plane. So we rented a car and we drove to Rochester, Minnesota, stopping at a Subway in Wisconsin that I'm surprised we made it out alive. And so I'm the only person that has ever flown to Rochester, Minnesota, and driven to Rochester, Minnesota on the same day. I couldn't go any farther without thanking Lisa Johnson, who was my secretary for 35 years, and somehow had managed to get me to every place I was supposed to be on time. I was the Associate Dean of Academic Affairs, which is a 20-hour-a-day job, and I was a basketball coach and a baseball coach. It was a 10-hour-a-day job, and never really knew where I was going or where I was supposed to be or what I was supposed to do, but somehow she got me there every time. I want to thank Robin Riker, who is an associate dean here now, who has helped me for years with our student-athlete schedules to make sure that we didn't have conflicts with practices and games and early morning classes. You know, basketball players can't take 8 o'clock classes. We don't get home until 1 o'clock in the morning. And so I really appreciate her help. I want to thank all of my assistant coaches, Carrie Davis, who was with me most of the time with baseball, who was my pitching coach, who forgot more about pitching than I ever knew. Jason Rathbun, who did a beautiful tribute here. You know, he played for me for 2 years and went on to Erskine College on a baseball scholarship. And he was graduating and he called me up and he says, geez, coach, I don't know what I'm going to do. And I said, well, I know what you're going to do. You're going to come up here. You're going to be my assistant coach. You're going to work in the fitness center. And then next year, you're going to take over as baseball coach. And that's exactly what happened. PJ Anadio, who is the past softball coach, also was an assistant coach with me on the basketball team and played baseball for me. Matt Tomeno, who was planning on being here tonight, but he lives in Florida. And I did talk with him today, and he and his family are doing fine. They got hit with a lot of water, but no wind damage at least. Jeremy Cingranelli, who has coached with me for I can't tell you how long, but left because we don't just call Jeremy Jer anymore. We call him Special FBI Agent Jeremy Cingranelli, which is why he no longer coaches basketball with us. I also want to give a shout out to Derek Felder, who was our captain on our national championship team, and who now works in the Advisement Center and is going to do a fabulous job. I thank him for really leading our team to that win. That's one of the best basketball players Herkimer has ever seen. And I'm pretty sure Derek will be following me here pretty soon. One of my former bosses, Tony Cleveland, said to me one day, I think we were driving to some meeting, and she said to me, you know, you are one of the luckiest people I know because you have such close, close friends. And I just want to thank those close friends for always having my back. Ray Johnson, who was introduced as our county legislature, Michael Oriolo, who is the provost here at the college, and Joe DiLorenzo, who surprised me by being here today. I know it's always nice to know someone always has your back. And of course, the last person I need to thank is Matt Lee, who is without a doubt one of the best basketball coaches in the country. You know, he's won 450, won 450 college basketball games. And I was there for all but 10 of them. We had a losing record. Our first year, we finished 14 and 16. Remember at Lakewood yesterday, we had to play the last game to try to get into the regionals. Would have been the first time we made the regionals. And we lost. We played the number one team. And we sort of looked at each other and said, that's never going to happen again, and it didn't. And we've made the regionals every single year. We've gone to the nationals 8 of the last 9 years, and in 2019, we won the championship. And so he's a terrific guy. You guys are lucky to have him. He's not only a terrific basketball coach, but he's a terrific person. He's a terrific employee. I was his supervisor for probably 10 years. And I can't thank him enough for accepting, and his family for accepting me into their family. The last thing I want to say is this. So my dad was my little league coach. I guess since I was probably 8 until I was 12. And he passed away, 40 years ago. And he took me to the Baseball Hall of Fame when I was 5 years old. And I was, like, just stunned by the whole thing. And he, anytime anybody would ask me, so what do you want to be when you grow up? I would say, I want to be in the Hall of Fame. And I can't be in that Hall of Fame, but I'm in this one, and this one's just as good. Thank you very much.
Ray Johnson, come on up for a minute. So he's going to present a proclamation to honor Hank Testa. Come on up.
Thank you. First of all, I'd like to congratulate all the inductees tonight. It's amazing listening to all your stories and everything you've done for this college. It's just an amazing institute. From a legislative standpoint, it's really nice to see what happens up here. A lot of times we don't get to see all the good. We get to see the other side. But without further ado, I get to call Hank friend. He also happens to be in my district. I won't read through the whole proclamation because it's pretty much been all set up there. The only thing, the last thing I'd like to say is Saturday, October 1st, 2022 is Hank Testa Day. The county. So come on and enjoy the whole council. Congratulations, Hank.
Okay, next up is the 2013 Herkimer College softball team. Under Coach PJ Anadio's leadership, this special group of young women won the first softball national championship in school history, and the only one to date. The 2013 team holds the record for highest win percentage in a single season by a Herkimer softball team, and they achieved a season record of, get this, 43-2. The team led the country in batting average. Now, they led the country in batting average, slugging percentage, and home runs. They were also in the top three for hits, runs, RBIs, on-base percentage, and fielding percentage. This team had three athletes named first-team All-Americans and two named second-team All-Americans. Watch the video.
There are a variety of reasons why the 2013 National Championship team is so special, but the one thing that comes to my mind immediately is that every single person on that team had a purpose, had a goal, and had the passion for softball, and you just don't get to experience that every day.
This really was about a great group of 19 young ladies that came together and played as the ultimate team to win the ultimate championship, a national championship. And, you know, this one has stood for probably longer than any of the coaches and myself would have liked it to, but it was a special group of ladies that came together, and it really, in the end, was all about them, their efforts, and what they produced on and off the field.
You know, coming from high school, you don't really know what to expect. A lot of us, you know, everything came easy to us. Our high school season came easy to us. We never really had to put in the work that you need to on the collegiate level. I can't remember how many times I wanted to quit softball at Herkimer. I can't remember how many times I gave PJ attitude, maybe like 25 to 50 times, no, probably more.
All of them, every single girl on this team could mash. They hit the ball very hard. As a first base coach, they made it very easy for me since they were such good hitters. Basically all I had to do was just point to second and they were on their way.
My most favorite memory from that season, besides obviously winning the national championship, was our game against Dutchess County, which was the game we had to win to make it to the national championship game. We were in the loser's bracket, and it was the bottom of the seventh inning, I think, and we were losing, and there were two outs, and I just remember, like, something just hitting all of us, like, come on, guys, we have worked this hard for so long. We can't let this be the end of Herkimer softball. We have to make it. We can do it. And one thing led to another, and I'm telling you, like, it was a string of hits. I mean, bloopers, bunts, stealing, whatever we had to do to win, we did it. And it's because of our passion, our heart, and we just wanted it so badly. And then after that, we went on to beat Brookdale twice, which is very hard to do, to beat the same team twice in a row. And, you know, after winning something as big as the national championship, it just hits you like that's the reason why we had to run up the hills, do the mop-ups, do the suicides, have 5-hour practices, do drills over and over again. It's because that day was so long and so strenuous, you know, we had the stamina for that, and that's just something, you know, you work hard for, and when you achieve it, it's one of the greatest feelings you'll ever feel, and I'm so happy that I got to experience that.
The bond that we have for life from something like this, we've been able to attend their weddings, see them have families and kids, see them succeed in their corporate life, their professional life. Become well-rounded people and young adults, and you know, it's just the stage was set back then by winning a national championship and like I said, the bond for life with them.
Many years go by, it's already been 9 years, but a lot of us, you know, we see each other on Facebook, Instagram, we sometimes text each other. We will always share that we have won a national championship together, and that's just something that you will have that bond forever, and I'm so thankful for it.
Please welcome the 2013 National Championship Softball Team. Alyssa Balfi, Stephanie Bianco, Delaney Buckley, Catherine Shalufo, Olivia Donosky, Alexa DeSpirito, Courtney Gumprick, Tina Karaki, Rebecca Kitchen, Shannon Lombardi, Alyssa Myers, Caitlin Nato, Jessica Paterelli, Briar Roseboom, Tony Secreti, Savannah Sergio, Samantha Smeldone, Ashley Starrett, Courtney Tasco, and coaches PJ Anadio, Steve Speno, Dan Staltieri, and Steven Sidaro.
She thought you were only going to get one plaque, you had to share it.
Sure, one right here. Speaking on behalf of the team is Delaney Buckley.
Wow, this is like A League of Their Own, but like not as old. So really excited to be a part of this. Let me just pull up my notes really quick. First off, I want to congratulate everyone here and being honored tonight. Definitely an elite group, so I'm very, very happy to be a part of it. And very happy to speak on behalf of the softball team. Don't know who let me do this, but... secondly, I want to thank the college. First off, obviously, this wouldn't be possible without the athletic department, the coaches, teachers, and everyone kind of buying into our ultimate goal. The fans, the supporters, the donors, most importantly, the alumni. Without putting Herkimer softball on the map, like, none of us would have been here. None of us would have made any of this possible. So thank you to everyone there. Cannot believe almost 10 years ago, we stepped foot up at the field. Only two returning sophomores and about 48 freshmen. So definitely a daunting task. We didn't know what was in store or if we'd make it through the first week. Coach PJ and the coaching staff did their best and sacrificed the most to help us be our best selves on and off the field. 8 short months later, we were competing in the national championship. So we figured it out. We got it all together and made it happen. The bond we built was unmatched. Through the years, we have taken on new titles professionally and personally. Some are moms, some are married, new last names, and whatnot. But one thing will always be consistent. We will always be teammates and we'll always have Herkimer. As time goes on, we'll reminisce at our time at Herkimer as the good old days, and they always will be. I can speak to everyone here at Herkimer, or on, everyone on the team, that Herkimer will always have a special place in our hearts. And what we accomplished here will now be hung in the hallways forever and remembered forever. Thank you.
And last, but certainly not least, tonight, the 1992 National Championship Men's Lacrosse Team. Under the leadership of legendary coach Paul Wareham, the 1992 team was the first lacrosse team in school history to complete an undefeated season and win a national championship. The 92 team finished 18-0, and they averaged 19.8 goals per game while allowing just 5.8 goals per game. 15 players from the 92 team received Division I scholarships as a result. Please watch the video.
What really stuck in my mind that made this one of the greatest teams that Herkimer ever had, and we had nine national championship teams here, and the one that really made them stand out was that they started the streak, but they started the streak because they were on a mission. And every team after that, for those five straight years, was on a mission. And they made sure they got it done. And they didn't want to be the first team not to win it. So those 5 years in a row, which started with the 92 team, and that's why they're being honored here tonight.
Most teams would crumble and break apart with all the adversity, but not the 92 team. When we lost Lewis Johnston, it had an immediate and huge impact on all of us. As my former teammate Sean Cross said, we could not describe the feeling we had as we were going to Lewis' hometown and see his family, but it wasn't something we were prepared for to deal with as college students when we arrived.
Very resilient, you know, and when things were tough, you know, like Merv's injury, they met up to every task that they had to. Got to know their families really well, not just, I mean, if we had a game in Albany, we usually had a get-together in Albany. If we had a game in Rochester or Syracuse, we usually had families helping feed the guys.
Coach Wareham was the glue that kept the team together. He had to make critical decisions without having any full-time assistant coaches helping him or giving him a new perspective. Whether it was a pat on the back, a kick in the butt, or just a dose of reality, he did it his way, and he did it the right way.
Schools they went to, like D1 Butler, we had four kids. Stony Brook, great school. Delaware had three. Springfield, Delphi, Marist, Alfred, Salisbury, Mount St. Mary's. We had kids going from Herkimer, going to Cornell from that team. Two to Syracuse, and they were captains of the team at Syracuse, and when we won the national championship for Syracuse. Penn State, UMass had another two, so they were great. They did a job, they did what they had to do in the classroom, and they were great leaders on and off the field. Exceptional senior class, and we had a lot of great kids. Of those guys that I named that went on to four-year schools, that's 32 kids, and that's pretty remarkable. For one junior college, we sent 32 kids on to Division I, Division II, and Division III teams. It was exceptional. Played a tough game out of Corning Community College. I mean, a long ride where you left here at 6 and you didn't get there till 11, you know, for a 1 o'clock game. That was a haul. And, you know, we barely beat them out there. And then later on in the year, we beat them in the regionals, in the regional championship game, Region 3. We beat them, I wrote it down, it was 25-3. So, you know, they were, you know, very resilient. The championship game was against Nassau. A lot of people don't even know who Nassau is. and Nassau Community College on the junior college level is like the Warriors or the Celtics. I mean, these are teams that don't lose. And we're playing Nassau, who wound up winning 22 national championships at a school of 21,000 students. And here we were, Herkimer, coming down there with less than 2,000 students playing Nassau for the national championship on Long Island. And we had an unbelievable game in the goal with John Ivory. You know, led us. He was a MVP. And, you know, it wasn't just John. We beat him 9-6, but it was a war. It really was. And these kids, they got it done.
The 92 team was the definition of a team. Yes, we had our fair share of superstars, but in the end, we put our egos aside and did what was best for the team.
Well, they're a very close-knit group, and couldn't be prouder of their being named it. One of the teams that's going to be remembered forever at Herkimer.
Help me welcome the 1992 team to the stage. Alexis Arguello, Scott Barnard, Thad Boyce, Scott Buttle, David Carman, Gary Sigleski, David Klesinski, Doug Klesinski, Peter Colburn, Sean Cross, Vincent Deliacono, Joe Glockner, Jeffrey Green, Stephen Hirsch, John Ivory, Michael Joyce, Sean Marsh, Tom McAuliffe, Eric Merkel, Donald Joseph Mosier, Jeremy Murphy, Brad Nelson, David Nazinski, Joseph Polisino, Jeremy Pratt, Alex Rozier, Donald Shea, David Signor, Jared Smith, Jason Sweet, Derek Tortora, Shane Zigowitz, and coaches Paul Wareham, Michael Margiotta, Frank Giordano, Joyce Mendel, and Brian Cramp. Speaking on behalf of the team, Joe Polisino and the four captains.
Thank you. Good evening. First off, I'd like to thank the committee and Herkimer County Community College for having this evening. Congratulations to all the inductees into the Hall of Fame. Hearing all of your accomplishments and accolades tonight was incredible to hear. Herkimer has a long-standing tradition of producing outstanding student-athletes, and for our class to be selected with this Hall of Fame class is an incredible honor, and our 92 team is proud to be going with all of you. all the student athletes tonight. I think one of the great things about us going last is to hear the message from all the athletes and teams that were inducted tonight. And the thing that resonated me with the most was they all talked about effort. And I think the effort is what made them Hall of Famers and took them to that next level. We'd like to thank, as a team, Tom LaPuma, Joyce Mandel, Frank Giordano, Fran Ash, Sandy with our equipment, and Brian Cramp as our trainer for all they did for our team. Our 92 team was a special tight-knit group, and we set our egos aside so we could accomplish the goal of being national champions. Our team was loaded with talent. However, we know that talent always doesn't win. Our team had the right mindset as well as the motivation to strive for greatness. We had Coach Wareham along with our four amazing captains, Jeremy Murphy, Brad Nelson, Scott Barnard, and Joe Glockner, and they were instrumental in keeping our whole team together and striving toward a path of greatness. Two members of our team that were integral to our success that are no longer here with us were Lewis Johnson and Shane Zigowitz. They were the epitome and definition of what Herkimer lacrosse was. Lou, he was a picture-perfect defender. From his physical play, his thunderous checks, and his all-out effort, he was what Herkimer defense looked like during that time period. He'd slug it out with everyone in practice and with his opponents on game day. Shane was a bulldog. He had a powerful build. He was a tough and physical dodger who would grind it out with the best, and he could also bring the heat from the outside with his overpowering crank shot. Besides both of these guys being great players, they were amazing people. Lou had a heart of gold and was always there for his friends both on and off the field, and Shane always had a wonderful sense of humor and contagious laugh that always put a smile on our faces. Lou and Shane were taken away from us way too soon, but they live within our hearts and memories. When I think of the 92 team, I think of family. A lot of that has to do with Coach Wareham. He would always ask us how our families were doing, our moms and dads, our siblings. He would have us get our mom's Mother's Day cards on Mother's Day. He would always call our parents Mr. and Mrs. He was very respectful with that, never called them by their first names. And he knew what our parents did for a living as well and always asked how they were doing. He was a people person, and I think that's what made Coach Wareham such a great leader. Coach was a perfect person for Herkimer lacrosse. We came in as boys, and he helped us grow and mature and become men. We learned to be respectful, hardworking, and to be positive role models on campus and the community. We volunteered on a safety awareness task force while we were here. We went around neighborhoods in Herkimer and Little Falls and talked about the importance of smoke detectors and fire extinguishers in homes. And some of us were also members of student government. Coach taught us that it wasn't just about lacrosse. It was about making a difference in life. And I know a lot of us have taken those life lessons and we have implemented them into our everyday lives. Some other memories that bring a smile to our faces are about Coach and his van. That van is something that I think a lot of us got to take a chance for a ride once in a while. We enjoyed coming back from games. Sometimes Coach would jump behind the counter at a restaurant and help with food orders. I recall one time coming back, I might have been from Cornell, and Coach actually went through the drive-thru window, and I think he gave the officials from our game some food on their way out. Coach even got out one time when we were in Albany, and he stopped traffic so we could make a game to Hudson Valley on time. He was an exceptional traffic cop. But best of all, from what we remember, and some of us were talking about tonight, when Coach would call a timeout, instead of us gathering on the field, he would roll a bucket of balls off, and we would do ground balls up and down the sideline until that timeout was over. What I think our team takes away most from this evening is that even though some of us haven't seen each other in 30 years, the bonds of our team, a brotherhood, is so strong that we connected, we picked up our conversations right like it was yesterday. Whether we were sitting in geology class, we were on Campus Meadows, College Hill, maybe grabbing a slice at Vinny's, or down on the railroad tracks for practice. It all comes back like it was 1992. As I recall Coach saying to us a few weeks after we had won the title that year, he told us that there would be days that you'd be outside, maybe painting the house, maybe mowing the lawn or walking the dog, and your memories would go back to that 92 season. And they truly do a lot for me. Brings a smile to my face every time I think about that time. And even though we went undefeated, we won a national title, and now we're in the Hall of Fame, it's the friendships and bonds with the teammates that I think we all cherish the most. After our time at Herkimer, we all moved on and went our separate ways, and I still remember that last day. And seeing all my teammates, and most importantly, best friends leaving and moving on to the next chapter of their lives. And when I think about that today, I can still feel in the pit of my stomach how difficult that was. Even though it was only 2 years of our lives here, it was probably two of the best years we ever had. The bonds, the friendships that have lasted 30 years and continue to stay with us forever. That the recognition that the school is giving us and inducting us into their Hall of Fame is truly special. and has brought the bond even closer. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts for inducting us into your school's Hall of Fame. In closing, I'd like to say that the plaques and the trophies and the medals and national championship rings and watches that we've earned will gather dust, but the memories we have will last forever. And tonight, you gave our class another memory, a memorable one that will last forever. No better day.
Don't go anywhere yet. We're almost finished. I'd like to take a moment and extend my heartfelt congratulations to all those who are honored this evening. It's been an exciting night for Herkimer College and certainly for each of the inductees. And I have to say, it's been a special night for myself as well. And here's why. It's been a number of years since we've been up here. 2017 was the last time. And we went through a pandemic. And we lost a lot. We lost a lot of time spending time with people we care about and people we want to share times with. You lost time with teammates. You lost time with friends. We're making up for it tonight. 2022 Hall of Fame induction ceremony plaques will be on display in the lobby following the ceremony. And it was a special night for me because I was able to see just how special it was for the inductees. And that's what's important, is to remember those that mean so much to us, especially with what we have gone through these last 2 years. So, in a few weeks, we're going to take those plaques and we're going to move them to the display in the main corridor in the PE building where they will be seen forever. Right now, I'd like to bring up Nick Leno. He's going to close out the program with some final remarks.
Okay, folks, very quickly here, I want to congratulate all the inductees. I'm very proud of all of you and everything that you've accomplished. I just want to take a moment here to talk a little bit about sometimes the challenges that we have in junior college athletics. Junior college athletics is kind of like a grind, okay, and how we try to get through it financially. One of the things that we started about back in 14-15, we created a athletic endowment fund. That fund now has close to $300,000 in that fund. Our ultimate goal is to create a fund with $1 million. Our next benchmark would be $500,000. This is going to help our athletes in many ways. It's getting them to the games, feeding them, traveling. And I'll tell you a story, because sometimes as we win, it gets more expensive and my stress goes up. I'm trying to figure all this out. So Mr. Dutcher one day said, and a few coaches, I said, I figured it out. I got this whole thing figured out how we're going to fund this program. And so Donnie was smiling. He says, how? I said, if we just lose, it'll be easy. But we know we're not going to do that because we're the home of the champions. So I'd like everybody here to consider. Some of us now have moved on where we're successful, professional. People like Gino Barbuto is why this athletic program is still going, and a lot of other friends like him. Please consider making a donation to the Herkimer College Athletic Endowment Fund for not only the present, but more important, the present and the future, and that will preserve our history. Thank you so much, Jason Paulus. Great job. See you on the news tonight.
everybody. Have a great night, and that'll be our program. Thank you so much. Hey, partner.